We're under an enhanced risk for severe weather tomorrow. That's a level 3 out of 5. Later this evening through around midnight, some heavier clusters of showers coming through. Some of these storms having the potential to rotate. Gradual strengthening expected as it works its way through the Yucatan Peninsula, through the Gulf of Mexico by midweek. And then, of course, expected to weaken once it makes landfall. But the potential for some tropical style rain possible for the Carolinas. 175 mile an hour winds. Same wind speeds as Hurricane Katrina at its maximum. Gusts up to 185. Its trajectory west at 8 miles per hour. And the path really not changing all of that much as it continues to crawl Monday and Tuesday, skirting up likely the Florida Peninsula and then getting hooked by a mid-level trough and being swept out by the Carolinas a little later on in the week. Here we go, another new tornado warning for Brunswick, New Hanover counties. That's going until 545. That couplet you mentioned earlier, Gannon,
they're
now prompting
like dominoes.
That warning. So your alert tones are going off right now if they are set up. Again, extreme southern New Hanover County, Brunswick County into the thick of this. This one going also until 545. Severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado near Fort Fisher, Keary Beach, moving northwest at a quick pace, 30 miles an hour. See the little hooks that we're looking at on the radar here. Again, now Columbus County, the primary threat right now for this tornado that included Brunswick and Columbus County, and moving just close, if not into Pender County or the New Hanover Pender County line for this other system here as well. So lots of lightning, a wider view, the outer bands here of Dorian continuing. This is that rotation near Rich Inlet.
Well, moving that's what I was just talking about.
Yeah, that's right near Rich Inlet. So that's moving at 40 miles an hour, and there's that rotation that we're talking about. It's on your screen right now. If you want to hop on over to Max 2, give you an idea of where that rotation is. We're told that we have pictures from there. Remember, Sheriff Ingram was talking about that earlier.
Absolutely.
We have pictures of that. Oh, check it out. Yeah, on the Facebook page. It's on right now. Trees down on top of a car. Wow. That's incredible. No injuries. Gannon, I think we had talked about this earlier, but now we can actually put pictures with this.
Goodness.
Check that out. That's just astounding. You notice the eye wall kind of closing in on itself. Looks like it's going through an eye wall regeneration cycle right now. Showers staying offshore for us, clouds thickening up. And then as those showers come through, a little bit of mixed precipitation rolling through parts maybe of Raleigh and Greenville. But for us, this likely to be a rain event. And that's just giving the timing that this comes through. Mainly a rain and wind event for us today. Minor tidal flooding and beach erosion. Can't be ruled out either, but severe storms, wintry precipitation, not in the cards with this. It's just too warm. With a low pressure system, that's going to work its way just to the south of the Carolinas, but it's going to have enough strength to pump in a lot of moisture and some heavy rainfall. This front really taking its time to come through. In addition, some clouds on the back end of this will keep skies a little more congested than we initially thought yesterday. With the potential impacts, mainly stray tornadoes, heavy downpours of 1 to 3 inches, if not locally more, and some damaging wind gusts, tropical storm force wind gusts, as a matter of fact. Some poor drainage flooding a possibility also, but keep in mind, we're in pretty good shape right now to handle a lot of this rain, as for the most part, it's been ever so dry.
This is Gabe Ross with your First Alert weather.
Thanks for sticking with us on Carolina in the Morning Sunday. Let's recap those rainfall totals. The heaviest rains falling in New Hanover and Pender counties, especially Pender County, to the tune of over 1.25 inches in a lot of spots. Surf City, one of those areas. Castle Hayne here in New Hanover County getting in close to 1 inch, and a couple spots in Brunswick County with impressive rainfall totals to report near 0.5 and 1/4 inches, respectively, in Leland and Supply. Turnbull Creek picking up a couple hundredths of 1 inch of rain, and then as far as our Mesonet sites go, in Columbus County, we haven't had any readings showing up as of yet. When we do get numbers from Columbus County, anything we get, we'll be sure to pass those along to you, of course. Quiet now. Here we are some 6 hours later. Shower activity now diminished. The heavy stuff well offshore. But boy, what a night it was. frequent lightning, loud thunder, likely woke you up in the middle of the night. Well, the good news, that's done, and actually the next few days looking to be pretty nice. Some good intervals of sun, and overall, gusty breezes. So that'll be the big focus, along with warm temperatures here in the short term. Into the upper 70s to lower 80s inland, gusts in the mid 20 mile an hour range. Skies will start to clear out tonight as we drop back rapidly into the lower 50s and upper 40s for some. Breezes go from the west to the northwest, so that means cooler air coming in. Mostly sunny, cooler and comfy, we'll call it, but rain chances pretty well off the board. We'll time everything out with your cloud and future radar model, getting that into motion. Few clouds working in late morning, early afternoon, but late this afternoon and evening, things looking much better. Stray showers possible off to the north and in the mountains of the Carolinas, but for us, not going to be the case. A few more clouds working in late morning tomorrow through early afternoon, but no showers really to speak of. All that moisture staying well offshore for us. Tracking your temperatures going through the morning. Boy, yesterday, kind of a cool start in the upper 50s and lower 60s, starting out in the upper 60s and low 70s for us. Here we are, peak heating in the afternoon with those temperatures in the upper 70s to the lower 80s. We're going to allow a little bit of flexibility for that, and then coasting back pretty well through the 60s and eventually the 50s tonight. Here's 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. Might need a windbreaker first thing, too, with those sustained west breezes. At times above 10 miles an hour. Newworth Motors First Alert Sky Camera views from across southeastern North Carolina. If you were watching the broadcast at the bottom of the 8 o'clock hour, you might have noticed some sun peeking through. Well, the clouds have moved back in, obstructing that sunshine a little bit. Temperatures now more in the lower 70s amid south and southwesterly breezes. Here's your planning forecast highlighting that dry start to the week and then the unsettled midweek ahead, mainly coming Wednesday night and Thursday. Temperatures during that time maintaining pretty well in the mid 70s, so pretty seasonable temperatures, but a drier finish to the week. Overnight lows back in the mid and upper 50s by then. Gabby? What better way to start your day with a little breakfast? And if you really enjoy something like bacon, well, the Bacon Fest is wrapping up today, 11 a.m. to 5 over at Old Homestead Farm in Rocky Point. Forecast looks like it's going to be cooperating, but a warm one at that. In fact, temperatures challenging record highs for the daytime. So when you step outside on a day like today, you might feel dew points in the 60s to near 70, and you know, you can sense the humidity in the atmosphere. But in the days ahead, we're likely to get some lower dew points, so 60s and 50s and even low 50s, as a matter of fact. And that's where you're going to get that crisp fall feel outside, and that's where we'll wind up by the end of the week. What months saw the most rain? That would be April, August, September, and November. Of course, September, that came from Dorian, but already finishing above average. So only 4 months this year. You remember last year, we went much higher. In fact, two record-setting months for the most amount of rain coming in May, and then September, of course, with Hurricane Florence. That was also the year that we went over 100 inches of rain. NASA just launching Boeing's orbital flight test to the International Space Station, and check out the contrail you're seeing in the upper atmosphere. We could see it here in southeastern North Carolina. Clear skies making for some superb viewing here this morning. Between yesterday and today, 30 years ago, picking up close to a foot of snow, actually about 10 and a half inches overall. When this whole system was said and done through Christmas Eve, we wound up with close to 15 and a half inches. And just take a look at the video from our WECT archives. First, a warm front that'll bring in southerly air, propelling temperatures into the 50s and 60s. The second end of the story will be a cold front that'll usher in a better line of showers late tonight through tomorrow and drastically cooler temperatures to start off the week. We've even seen 90 degree temperatures in March. That happened on March 23rd, 1907, 94 degrees, and that was the warmest temperature ever recorded during the month of March in Wilmington. In 1980, conversely, on the 4th, with the coldest temperature, a bone chilling 9 degrees. And in terms of rainfall, you have to go all the way back to 1936, because what a year it was in terms of rainfall for the month of March. We set a one-day record on the 10th for over 5 inches of rain. That month stands as the wettest month in Wilmington history for the month of March. The grill and forecast we're going to highlight now. Mike Marley slapping these bad boys on the grill. T-bones and porterhouse steaks. as we track that grill and forecast a little later on this morning. Temperatures upper 70s, lower 80s, mid-afternoon. That's when the temperature is the warmest. Your coastal zone is going to be a little cooler with the ocean water influence, of course. Then later tonight, traditional dinner time, 6, 7 o'clock, those temps back in the low 80s, but still a touch on that humid side. So this is day 4, expecting to go through the weekend. In fact, an excessive heat watch in effect for the lower Cape Fear come tomorrow. So that's even higher heat index values, in some cases pushing 110 degrees. You know, we had a 7-day streak this time in 2016, actually July 3rd through July 9th. And one of the longer streaks, you've got to go all the way back to June 2015. I remember that because I was just coming to Wilmington at that point, and boy, was it a hot one. Pool forecast on the screen right now. Your overall rating, a 9 out of 10. And you're probably wondering, why scrutinize the numbers so much? Well, it's because of a chance of an isolated shower or storm. So that, of course, could always derail your pool plans. You want to pay very close attention to the clouds and to the sky in case a thunderstorm pops up. You want to get out of the pool, of course, but they're very much of the splash and dash variety, so that they're one moment, gone the next. And you know, tonight, the final downtown sundown concert of the season. What a way to go out. Departure, a Journey tribute band, taking the stage at 8 o'clock tonight, Striking Copper before them at 6:30. The alcohol wristband sales benefiting the Wilmington Professional Firefighters Association. A great reason to get to market in 2nd Street tonight, along with some beautiful weather. Mid and low 80s, even some mid 70s by the time the concert wraps up. Bob, can you read this word here?
Oh, I should have warned you.
Triskaidekaphobia?
Forget your triskaidekaphobia.
I can't see the first part, but I know the triskaidekaphobia part.
Forget triskaidekaphobia.
How did you know that? Did you hear him say it earlier?
No, I know that's the fear of the 13.
There it is. So Bob at least is more on top of it, I think, compared to most people.
Well,
I was waiting for him to say it.
I appreciate that.
More on top of it than Kim. Thank you very much.
Your words, not mine, right?
Right.
One of two Friday the 13ths in 2019. The other one comes in December. And then we've got more, of course, in 2020. And also, it's a full moon tonight. It's the harvest moon. That takes place just before 1 a.m., the start of the full moon cycle. And if you're counting Halloween, 48 days away. Do you have your costume picked out? I don't. Maybe someday.